Good stuff, John. Hey folks, how you doing? Andy with you for another video. Today I have my good friend with me, John Snooks. And welcome along, John. Good to have you along. Another guest in for a video, which is great. So you play slide, and it's something that I've never done before, so I thought it'd be a great opportunity to show you folks out there a bit of the world of slide, learn a bit myself as well, because it's something I've always been kind of keen on. But it's something, you know, I've bought a slide guitar, but I've never done the whole, you know, sit down type thing. And the thing that you guys will notice straight away is if you have a look, you'll notice that the strings are raised here, which is the biggest difference, isn't it, with it sort of physically for the guitar.
You got to have clearance between the fretboard and the strings.
Yeah.
And you don't want too much, but about a quarter of an inch. 4 or 5 mil or something like that. It's good.
Otherwise you get horrible noise, don't you? As soon as you put that slide on, you end up hitting the fretboard.
Some people use high action, ordinary guitar, but it doesn't give you the flexibility that this does.
Yeah, cool.
The other thing I've found is that there's a myriad of different tunings you can use with these, but the simplest to start off with is what's called A major high bass.
Yeah, what are the notes for that? Nice. What are the notes?
You can get sevenths and ninths and all that sort of stuff.
But what are the open strings there?
E, C sharp A.
E, C
sharp A.
Oh wow.
Simple A major.
Two times the same thing.
Yeah.
So there you go, that's a good starting tuning for anyone who wants to get into doing a bit of slide. So for anyone who's unaware, you can tune your guitar to different tunings. The standard tuning when you get a tuner and you tune your guitar is obviously E, A, D, G, B, E, when you get there with a tuner. So you can do other tunings. Now, a lot of people don't know that, you know, that's you kind of get used to that. But I remember it was a good, I don't know, 2 years before I learned, you can do different tunings, you know, there's these open tunings. So if you were just to strum that open.
Yeah, or.
Or any fret. You get a chord. Yeah, whereas if you strum a open guitar, it's a chord, but it's not particularly nice, it's not particularly interesting, whereas with slide, that's what you can do, hey?
The other thing, by tuning like that, you can have, on some songs, including the one we just did, you can play in 3 octaves.
Yeah, right. Like, can you demonstrate that? Yeah. Yep.
That's a bit of a help if you want to vary instead of standing the same all the time.
Yeah. So for getting into slide, did you play regular guitar to start with, or did you get straight into slide?
No, my father and his brother used to play Hawaiian songs on 70X years ago, a half-hour live session. And I got hold of his guitar one day when I was about 6 or 7.
Yeah.
And he had tab music written. And he used to just show me what he did.
Yeah.
And those days you used to play your own accompaniment. So you used a low bass tuning, which was different again.
Oh, wow.
So you used these two strings for accompaniment.
Wow.
And that was the style those days. But it's just sort of, for what I do, I find this is the easiest.
Yeah.
The other thing, you need a steel which is perfectly flat. Mm-hmm. The strings need to be flat. So that if you need to play that, you get across the string.
Yeah, so that's an issue with different guitars. Different guitars will be set up so the strings will have a bit of curvature, which goes with a lot of necks. Like your neck's got a bit of curve. On a classical guitar like this, it's pretty flat, but that can be set up on your guitar. You know, I'm just using a classical here because it was sitting around. But setting that up on the bridge here so that the strings are flat, that's another factor as well for anyone getting into it for the first time.
Yes, you need to be able to adjust your strings up and down and also this way.
Yeah.
So that when you get up here, you're still in tune.
Yeah, your intonation there.
Yeah.
Yeah, great.
So you need a bit of flexibility.
Mm. Check out the Nail Guitar Skills channel to learn more guitar skills. And check out my other channels for heaps of free guitar training videos. If you're on Facebook or Twitter, you can catch me there also.